The second step, we are supposed to explain it for more than one particles to be evaporated from the nucleus. And now in this time, what happens? The stuck nucleon leave the nucleus and the residual nuclei is left with smaller amount of energy. So now more than one particles are evaporated, are kicked out, and the residual energy, the residual nucleus gets less amount of energy, and now the amount of energy which is still in excess, it has to be emitted or evolved. Now nucleus gets enough time to distribute this remaining energy uniformly throughout its area, and then normal evaporation process settle the issue of excitation or excess energy. So the residual excitation energy loss then normally occurs by evaporation of certain particles, as has been explained by the compound nucleus theory. So this is the only difference between the two theories. One is combined nucleus theory and the other one is direct interaction, which was proposed by R. Serber. So in case of direct nucleus, this compound nucleus model, so in compound nucleus model, nucleus interacts overall, while in direct interaction, the mechanism proposed by R. Serber, here the interactions is either with an individual particle or considerable time in the range of 10 raised to the power minus 19 second is given to the system. It's more than one particles are evaporated with high kinetic energy, and the residual nucleus then gets less amount of energy, which follow then the compound nucleus path. Now this is the explanation of the theory diagrammatically. So here we have again, this figure has been adopted from the book written by Chopin. So here we have five different diagrams. This is bombarded, let's suppose, particles, and this particle is preferably neutron. So inside the nucleus there are more neutron and proton, more than one. So the solid particles, they represent protons, and the empty particles or hollow particles, they are neutron, or you can consider vice versa. What happens now? This particle interacts directly with an individual proton. So whenever this individual proton is hitted by a high energy neutron, what happens? It is kicked out. This is kicked out, and in next step, what happens? Neutron also leaves the system, or this is also kicked out. So in this case, from A to C, one proton and one neutron, and definitely these protons and neutrons have high energy. They are produced, and these high energy particles were not explained by the combined nuclear model or nucleus theory. Now, after kicking out these particles, what happened? This normal nuclei is deformed, and now this nuclei is called combined nuclei. Now the combined nuclei has although excess of energy, and this energy has to be stabilized. The system will come back to stability. So whenever it comes back to stability, normal procedure or normal path which was followed in the case of combined nuclear model will be followed, and again a proton or neutron will be evaporated along with a gamma ray, and this phenomena can be explained by compound nuclear model or compound theory, compound nuclear theory. So now cross section versus bombardment energy, which we already have discussed, that this is excitation function, and this excitation function for this reaction, for example, this is cobalt. Cobalt is bombarded by high energy proton, and a proton and neutron and a cobalt with atomic mass 58 is produced. Another reaction where the same cobalt is bombarded by a proton, but the energy of this proton will be different from this proton. And four protons and eight neutrons are produced along with a chromium nucleus. In diagram, or this is the reaction, cobalt bombarded by a proton to give cobalt plus proton plus neutron. This diagram we have already discussed, that whenever the kinetic energy of bombarded particle increases, so at certain amount the cross section also increases. Cross section means nucleus will be susceptible to reaction at certain amount of energy, and this amount of energy is here in this range. So this curve is sharp. Now what happens that a neutron is a proton is evaporated as well as a neutron, and this curve, now we have to explain it, the energy required or minimum energy, or we can say the optimum energy required for this reaction is 12 to 35 mega electron volts. So in 12 to 35 mega electron volts, the excitation function is sharp. And for the, it is for the compound nucleus. The tail is related to the phenomena that neutron is kicked out and then the proton leaves. So neutron is first followed by proton, and this is then independent of proton energy. So here in this case, then the energy doesn't matter. So in this case, if we want to carry out this reaction, so here in this region the no reaction will be absorbed, and then the decrease is slow. The slow rise in cross section for this reaction, where proton has been bombarded on the target particle and 4 proton and 8 neutrons are produced, so this reaction is knock-on process. That one was the first step, which we explained that Erserber explained the mechanism in 2 steps. So this was the first step, and in this case a high energy particle, more than 1, are produced, and this is knock-on process. So in this, now knock-on process starts and it ends into evaporation, and after evaporation then the nucleus come to its ground state, and the required stability is gained, and no further nuclear reaction can be absorbed. Thank you.